In our last lesson, one piece of evidence we mentioned for the Big Bang was this hot glowing fog. In this video, we're going to talk about where this hot glowing fog comes from. In particular, we're going to explain how this idea can be derived from running the universe backwards.
So here we are running the universe in reverse. And you can note that everything in the universe is getting closer, that is, the density is increasing back in time, and also that the energy of all the particles is increasing. That means the universe is becoming hotter. So let's look at the physical consequences of the universe getting denser and more energetic.
What we want is a glowing fog. Glowing fog is where the matter and the radiation are tied to each other. The matter emits radiation, radiation is scattered. That's what makes it glow and a fog. So we need to think about how matter interacts with radiation. Now, radiation is an electromagnetic wave, an oscillating electric field, which we've shown as a vector behind Brian over there. And here is some matter. This is my crude model of a hydrogen atom. So we've got the proton down here, chemically bonded, which I've shown as a spring, to an electron.
So we've got a photon and an atom.
And what you can see is because these things are bound together, they're not having much effect on each other. The electron has got a negative charge, the proton has a positive charge, the electric field pulls one way, the other way. But because they're bound together, it has no overall net effect. They might vibrate very slightly, but nothing much happens.
So it's sort of like being a convict with a chain, you know, on you. You can't do much.
That's right. So to make a universe full of hydrogen atoms like this is going to be a transparent universe. The radiation and the matter is going to go straight past each other without noticing.
Right.
What we need then is to break the bond, snap the chain. So what we've got here is the bond has been broken, and you can see the electron is now doing quite a lot of jiggling.
So it's moving a lot, and the proton is moving just a little bit. Presumably that's because the proton's 1,800 times more massive than the electron, so it moves a lot less even though it's being affected by an electric field the same way.
Yes, we've got a situation like this where in particular the electrons are free to move around, then it's going to be opaque. And a moving accelerating electron is a little radio transmitter. It broadcasts radiation. So the radiation comes in, it affects things very dramatically, and they then radiate out in return. So if you have a universe where these things are split up, it's an opaque universe, that's our glowing fog.
So that electron will scatter the photon. The photon will come in and bounce off it, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So one thing we need to know is that to knock an electron out of a hydrogen atom, you can do that with energy. And it turns out you need 13.6 electron volts of energy to do this. Now, Paul showed us that the average energy of a typical photon in the universe is 10 to the minus 3 electron volts, divided by the scale factor compared to the current scale factor. So if we want to get up to 13.6 eV, we really need to have the scale factor be about 10,000 times smaller than it is today. And in that case, a typical photon will be able to, when it strikes a hydrogen atom with an electron, knock that electron off its proton.
That's giving us the glowing fog. And in fact, you don't need a universe 10,000 times smaller. About 1,000 times will do it. The reason is the equation on the previous slide was talking about the typical photon. But we don't really care about the typical photon. What we care about is the most energetic photons. Here is a spectrum of photons we see today. Here's a typical one. These are the more energetic ones and the less energetic ones. There aren't very many which are 10 times more energetic, but you don't need very many because photons outnumber normal particles, baryons, by a billion to one. So if even one or two in a billion is 10 times more energetic, that's enough to smash all the electrons out of the atoms and give us our glowing fog. So it turns out if you do the sums, you need a universe with a scale factor about 1,000 times smaller than today to turn it into this glowing fog.
All right, so let's just show a sort of a cartoon of how this works. So here we have a universe full of photons, the little guys, and hydrogen atoms, the big guys, and the photons are literally bouncing off the hydrogen atoms here.
So this is what the universe would have been like for the first 300,000 years or so when the scale factor was less than 1,000 times what it is today, with the photons in large numbers and the baryons, the normal matter, bound together. But slowly as time went on, things are expanding, the speeds are getting less, and eventually the energies will get so low, just happened there, that the electrons can recombine. They call it recombination. I don't know why they've never been combined before. It's called recombination. They combine with the protons to form neutral hydrogen atoms, and now they're transparent. You can see the photons can go straight through these atoms now. And this is the universe we live in today, a transparent universe.
So imagine we are here in the center. We look out. What do we see? we see a sea of photons coming from all directions. These photons are the photons that were bouncing around in the universe when it was foggy, and then the universe became transparent, and these photons traveled until they reached us here on Earth today, giving us a picture of what the universe looked like when it was 1,000 times smaller than it is right now.
And the sea of photons are called the cosmic microwave background, and this is the first of the triumphs of the Big Bang Theory. The triumph that it predicts that we should be living in a sea of photons coming from all directions, and furthermore, it predicts that we should have exactly the spectrum. This is a combination plot showing both data and theory for what the spectrum should look like, plotting the same graph.
That line is both theory and data?
Yes, it's got error bars on here, but the error bars are so small you can't even tell them for the thickness of the line on this pixel.
That's a pretty good prediction.
It is. So if you want to come up with a rival theory to the Big Bang, you have to be able to explain why we are in the sea of photons, and you have to be able to predict exactly why the spectrum should have this shape and none other.
So in summary, the cosmic microwave background is the photons left over from the Big Bang when the universe was foggy, full of electrons and photons scattered around. They have come straight to us from when the universe was 1,000 times smaller than it is today. And they provide this very strong evidence that the universe was once hot, dense, and opaque, something any decent theory that describes the universe is going to have to explain.